don't know. I'm going to figure out something. I don't care if I got to get out there this week and go door to door and invite every parent from Moses McCoy and say, if y'all come in, we're going to serve y'all this week. We just want you to come in. We want to love on every mother. We want to love on you. If y'all will come, we'll love on you. I'll do my part. But what I'm not going to do is use this opportunity to begin to point the finger. Yes, we can say, why were they outside? We can do that all day, but they were. And now the baby is gone. Okay? The baby is gone. We will resume proactive teaching after we give them a chance to grieve for their loved one. My God, people, where is your compassion? My God. And so, I don't know how I got on that, but what was I talking about?
Witchcraft.
Lord, how did that get me on that? Witchcraft. Now, I got to do this quickly. So, and for those that are here, if you got here late, I'm telling y'all, y'all just missed church. It's for real. It went down up in here today, didn't it?
Amen.
But let me say this. Witchcraft varies. Now, sexually, yes. Let me show you how Jezebels move sexually. Give me Proverbs 7, quickly. As a matter of fact, you got 7 already?
Amen.
Where do you want to start, D?
Verse 10.
No. Drop back to verse 5, quickly.
Amen. That they may keep thee from the strange woman.
Keep thee from a what woman?
Strange woman.
Now, the strange woman is not, don't mean she weird, don't mean she wear funny clothes. Strange here in the Bible is the woman that's under the power of a Jezebel spirit. She's called strange because this is a foreign spirit, one that you can't see coming when it comes. Now, let me just help y'all out. This might be a man, okay? Especially you that's dating, you that's single. Let me tell you this. Be careful who you let come into your life because some of them may be strange. Keep going.
From the stranger which flattereth with her words.
Stop. Didn't we just say that the way we're seduced is through charming of words.
Amen.
You better keep reading.
Amen. For at the window of my house, I looked through my casement.
Uh-huh.
And beheld among the simple ones, I discerned among the youths a young man void of understanding.
See, what you're seeing going on out there is a people who are void of understanding. Simple ones. Amen. Listen.
Passing through the street near her corner, and he went the way to her house.
Yes.
In the twilight, in the evening, in the black and dark night.
Yes,
and behold,
you know, a lot of stuff get done dirty in the dark.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Amen.
The freaks come out at night.
Amen.
That's what the Bible teaches. Did y'all hear what he just said? Amen. Y'all laughing, but I'm telling you that's what the Bible says.
Amen.
Come on.
And behold, there met him a woman with the attire of a harlot. And
she had on the clothing of a whore. I better leave that alone. Keep reading.
And subtle of heart.
Uh-huh. You know, clothing carries a personality. Amen.
Amen.
Dress for the job you're trying to get. Amen. If you don't want to be treated like a whore, don't dress like one.
Amen.
That go for men too. Amen. Now the men dress like whores. Y'all do want to hear the truth, don't you?
Yeah.
I'm just answering the question that we're going home. Yes, men, they show their figure too now. Seducing you women. I can't understand why a woman would want any man to look like them. But I guess it's working. Hey, man, what'd you call them? Jeggings. Keep reading.
She is loud and stubborn.
She's loud and stubborn.
Her feet abide not.
If I had time, listen, when I teach on Jezebel, don't miss it. You'll know her. One way you'll know her, not all the time, but she's loud and stubborn. You know when you got your stubborn Jezebel spirit, she'll drive you crazy. He'll drive you crazy, and they won't let off. They'll stay there to finish you off. Oh, Lord, it's quiet here today.
Amen.
We got some Jezebels in this church today.
Amen.
Keep reading.
She is loud and stubborn.
Yes.
Her feet abide not in her house.
Her feet abide not. Uh-huh. That goes two ways. You can have feet that abide not in your house and still be in your house by way of telephone.
Amen.
You ain't got to leave the house to leave your house.
Amen.
See, I'm getting too far into this. Keep reading.
Now is she without, now in the streets, and live and wait at every corner.
Yes, sir. She's looking for the opportunity.
So she caught him.
Listen.
So she caught him and kissed him, and with an impudent face said unto him,
It's one thing to kiss a fool. Huh?
Amen.
Another thing for a fool to kiss you. But you messed up if you get fooled by the kiss. Go ahead.
I have peace offerings with me. This day have I paid my vows.
Let me tell you what the Jezebel spirit will do when we get into, even in marriages, when we get into it later, not today. Watch for the peace offering. When you're on to Jezebel's trail and you find out that it's working, you recognize them in a man or a woman, huh? When you recognize that spirit, when they know you starting to get on to them, they may offer you a peace. And let me tell you why it's really called a peace offer. It's because anybody that really dealt with a Jezebel spirit know the one thing they rob you of. And so if you do what I say, I'll give you a temporary token of peace. But let me tell everybody a secret. Jezebel don't never retire. The only way you're going to get rid of her is to get rid of her.
Amen.
So don't try to pray her away. Don't try to just stand and just be there and take it. Don't wait till it blow over. If you got a Jezebel spirit, whether it's a husband or a wife, or if it's somebody that's in your life, that's working in your life, they're not going anywhere. So you might as well decide you're going to just knuckle up and face it. Because it's not going to just stop and get tired. Demons don't get tired.
Amen.
Okay. Amen. Read.
Therefore, came I forth to meet thee, diligently to seek thy face, and I have found thee.
What verse you on, Deacon?
That was in the 15.
Now, we're going to stop. Let me show you some more. Proverbs 2:16. Then give me Proverbs 5. And then I promise I wouldn't teach on Jezebel, so I just give you a few more things to think about. How she relates to sex. How seduction and sex go hand in hand. Because let me say this. One of the number one victims is one that can be considered codependent. What's a codependent? Listen to me. That's why we got to address what's going on with us. Because if you can't address what's going on with you, a Jezebel spirit will have you thinking you can't make it without them. And that won't be because they're so great. It'll be because you got a need that's so big. And that spirit comes in to seduce you based upon your need. So what we need to do is find out who we are, but by finding out who God is, find out how much he loves us so we can start loving ourselves.
Amen.
And then when we can love ourselves, even if it hurts, we can walk away from some things and some people if we have to until they get their act together or maybe for good. Why? Because we're no longer codependent.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Another word for this is called a narcissist. When I get finished, I'm going to be able to teach that like you've never seen it before. A narcissist. It's another word for a Jezebel.
Amen.
And they thrive off of your attention. They see you come home. When you come home, they see the husband or the wife is aching. She aching because she desire for her family to love God, but there's no peace. There's nothing but separation.
Amen.
Everybody can see it. And you're trying to hide it from people, but everybody in the church can see it. And that stubborn Jezebel spirit start pulling moves. Let me tell you what it'll do. It'll start doing things to put you on blast so that you feel embarrassed to make you curl up. Now I got to curl up. Why are you curling up? I've got to curl up because I don't want you to do nothing too much. That's what Jezebel. Ain't nobody saying nothing in here. You know why? Because it's all over the building.
Amen.
Control the home. Children control the home. Wife control the home. Look, can't you sit across? Wife give you a look. You freeze up. Husband, he can look at you. Scared to death, verbally abusing you women. Talking down on you. Some of you don't even know how great you are because you've been in situations where you've been abused so long mentally that you actually with somebody don't even really even deserve the ground you walk on, but you don't know it because they've reversed the role.
Come on now.
Look, God already refreshed the place. I got to come bring some other stuff. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Find out who you are. Know who you are. Amen. You can love. You don't know, Pastor, I love them so much. Yeah, you love them so much, but when they going to love you back?
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on, say yeah.
Amen.
We got to love you back. You're not going to control me today, Jesse. I'm going to church. If you don't go to church, then everybody would just see that you ain't walking with God. You ain't going to make me look bad. You ain't going to put me in no corner. I ask for me in this house, I'm going to serve the Lord. That go for men, that go for women. You sit at home if you want and let your partner keep you from the things of God, and you're going to find out your whole life will go down the drain. When I teach on Jezebel, I know I seem like I started, but when I teach on it, I'm going to talk to the men who become eunuchs. Spiritual eunuchs, you've been castrated. You let a woman take your manhood away. That's what Jezebel does. She always seeks to castrate her victim. Treat you like a little boy. Stand up, men, pray for each other. And this is not a physical battle. This is not just saying, I'm coming in the house. No, you're going to have to be praying. You're going to have to be in your word, because you're not fighting against a little one. You're fighting against principalities. You're fighting against powers. You're fighting against rulers. Huh?
Amen.
We're going to talk about the spiritual eunuchs. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to talk about the need for approval. If you're a man or woman and you grew up and your parents left you, you will, listen to me. Can I tell you something? It's going to help you. You will find yourself in a dire need to hold on to people who don't mean you no good. Because you've been through so much abandonment in your life that now you decide, I don't want it no more. What kind of preaching is this? I could preach regular. I said regular. But I figure I just answer the question. I'm just talking. We already had church. I'm just answering the question and talking. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. Y'all can't say we ain't have church today.
Amen.
Amen. So yes, we'll talk about that. And it could be a generational curse. Generational curses are real. I'm going to teach on that as well. Please, for those that have been asking me, it's coming. Generational curses work. Okay? If you don't believe me, give me Exodus quickly. Exodus 18. I'm going to show you a little bit about generational curses. And we'll go into depth. We'll go in depth about it. Some of you that's having the stomach issues, the bowel issues, I guarantee you, you better be careful. You're having bowel, stomach issues. I guarantee you there's some things going on that are attaching you to a Jezebel spirit that's ripping your insides out. Let me tell you something. It's real. But it really stems from things that happened in your childhood. Huh? Lady came in church Wednesday night. I'd never seen her. One of my white sisters. She walked in. I'd never seen her before. Don't know her. I said, lady, I see a pencil writing over top of your head. She broke down. Her friend started pushing her. The lady's the head of the book club. She's a major author over 2 different books. That's all she does. One of their symbols for their Facebook page comes back, it's got a pencil. And so the Lord began to speak, and I told her, I said, all of these cysts. I said, where is all these cysts coming from? Y'all know I ain't know nothing about this lady's cysts. So then she nudged her again. You were there, sister? Were you, sister, ma'am, you were there? Were you there when that happened? Okay, all right, I ain't lying. So when after that, she said, I got something called polycystic ovaries. Never seen her day in her life. I said, that's coming from what happened with your mama. She broke down crying and said, how would you know? I said, what happens because of the relationship between you and your mother? This stuff is for real.
Amen.
It's real. Amen.
Amen.
Jezebel is real. It works in jobs. It works in schools. It works in politics. It works everywhere where there's control, where there's manipulation.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Now, here's what you do. How do you fight it? Become knowledgeable. Then surround yourself with prayer warriors, not everybody, because everybody don't need to know your business, that can help you get through it.
Amen.
Can your pastor help you? You bet I can.
Amen.
All right. Exodus 18, let me show you generational curses, because some people don't believe in that stuff. Quickly, Deacon.
Exodus 18 and verse
2 and 3.
2 and 3.
I'm going to answer a couple more questions. Next week, come on back, we're going to preach.
Amen. Then Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, took Zipporah, Moses' wife, after he had sent her back.
Yep.
And her 2 sons, of which the name of the one was...
Give me Ezekiel 18. Give me Ezekiel 18. Pardon me. I knew someone didn't sound right. Ezekiel 18. Look at verse 2. Let me show you generational curses, how they work. And then when you come back and we teach it, I'll show you what they are.
Amen.
You can find out if they're working in your life.
Ezekiel 18 and 2.
Yes.
What mean ye that you use this proverb?
What is a proverb? A wise saying. Come on.
Concerning the land of Israel.
Yes.
Saying the fathers have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge.
A wise saying about generational curses is our parents have eaten
sour grapes.
Bad food, have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are messed up. What does that tell you? Sins of the father, amen, can follow the what? The children.
Amen.
It's called a generational curse. There's a curse over you. Some of y'all, we need to break it. Some of us, of poverty. There are generational curses that are sexually related. There are generational curses that have to do with the occult and witchcraft. They're all types. Please keep coming. We're going to teach you about those. All right?
Amen.
All right. Give me the next question.
How much of a woman's man's past should we pay attention to when deciding on a mate? Should their past disqualify them?
All right. I need to teach this, but I'm going to give you a quick answer. Men, women, somebody talk to me quick. How much of somebody's past should matter when picking or selecting a mate? And I'm going to ask the men first, because I know what y'all, some of y'all going to say. Nobody going to talk. Oh, you think we should? You think their past should? Okay. Anybody got anything to add to that difference? Okay, minister said what now?
Have a relationship with the Lord, so you can't do
looking at past blood. Oh, now hold on. Now what are we going to do? We ain't going to start no fight. One brother said, look at all the past. My other brother said, if they have, and there's an if, they have a relationship with Jesus, allow their past to be there. Brother CD. Oh, which is why he put an if. Right. Well, see, what you're really saying is this. What you're really saying is it their past? Because anything that's past is gone. We got to stop. Huh? Yeah, I worried about it. But look, watch this. In other words, what he's saying is make sure the past is the past. Okay? Sister, can you... Oh, now y'all gonna make me talk for a minute. Hold on. Can you handle? You know what I tell people? You know what I tell people? If you gotta ask a whole lot, you don't probably need to know. Y'all ain't ready for that. Because if you gotta ask a whole lot, you probably don't need to know. Because some of y'all gonna fall in love and then find out. My brothers, how about, does it matter to you, Brother Austin, Derek, Brother Kelly? I ain't gonna mess with Austin, Derek. I don't wanna get him in no trouble. It matters to you, but does it matter to the point where if you found out a girl had a dirty past, would you steal? Oh, not you, I expected him to say that, and you said, so you said case by case. What you mean, this kid is, I can't speak freely. Can you put it into PG-13? And that's a risk that you got to be willing to. Yeah. You're going to be in trouble. All right, so listen. I'm not going to go any further. I'm just going to say this to y'all real quick, okay? All right, I like what y'all are saying and what y'all, but let's be honest. Everybody, brothers especially, sisters, does it matter to y'all? Because women are tend to be a little different. And I guess you ain't got much of a choice with the way men conduct ourselves. Does it matter? It matter to women. Ain't nobody got nothing to say but sister ma'am. No, I mean, come on, y'all. Y'all take men out everywhere. Y'all take men that blind, crazy, however. Now, I need to ask y'all, does it matter their past or not? Oh, you don't take them like that. All right. It matters? All right, let me just say this, because I can go all day, and y'all fronting. Y'all fronting. So let me say this real quick. We are some devious people. You know why we devious? I said we. Because, how can I say this without trying to offend nobody? Sometimes, brothers, we can be the most past. Our past are as heavy. If somebody could roll out a movie on the stuff we've done. And you ever notice? The ones that are like us, is, hold on, brothers, those of us that's tightest about that are the ones that, hold on, watch this. Let's just be real. We acted like the devil. We was the devil, right? Playboy devil. The more we want, the more devilment that's in us, the better of an angel we got a nerve to think we want. Y'all didn't hear me because y'all were talking. Have you noticed the roughest ones about somebody's past tend to be the ones that were worse? What? Say it, Kelly. Oh, Derek pointed at you. No, talk to me. Is that true? I'm not insinuating you got a bad past, Brother Kelly. But just in case you had one, is it true that we could be tight about this thing about women? Yes, I'm tight about it at times. I have been. I said we. I'm talking to trash. I said we. Listen, I'm making a point. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, let's be honest. Just, I'm not saying it's right, but be honest. We're the biggest devil, but we want an angel. And here's what you're doing is you're going to make me teach, and I can't get into this today. Because we teach our women to guard themselves and protect themselves. And then we indirectly push our men to be free by how we treat our daughters versus how we teach. And that's why some of our men are so disrespectful to women, because the women were taught to respect men, but the men were never taught to respect women. And you say, I don't believe that. Yes, you did. Let me tell you why. Let me tell you why. For those of y'all that got brothers, did your mama go like this? Fix your brother a plate. Make your daddy a plate. Help your daddy do it. Go in there and do this for your daddy, for your brother. Brother been outside. You been in there washing dishes and cooking. He done been playing ball outside. Get your brother something to drink. And you know what happens? You instill into them that they should honor and respect the male. And he just get to run free and play ball. And so there's a message that's being sent that we're not trying to send, but it's being sent. And what happens is we tell the women, guard yourself. You're precious. Save yourself. And then when the men do it, we smile and say, that's my boy. That's another teaching. I'll come back to that. Am I talking right? So then we raise male whores and shame the women for being the same thing. Can I tell you something? I'm going to tell you this. Yes, sir. Go ahead, Elder. Okay. 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 So it was a different level. And I admit, Okay, things have gotten worse, no question about it. Let me say this because I got to answer two more questions and we're going home. Watch this, y'all. We're going to do a teaching on this one day, a real teaching, on why we are the way we are. But let me just share this with you. Maybe if you're the devil, if you've been the devil in the past, maybe you need to take a little bit of what all my brothers said. Maybe you need to find out if they got a relationship with Jesus. That's what you said. Then I need to find out if their past is actually their past. Okay? And I need to give myself some type of reality check. Okay? Fellas, especially, if you were a whore, male whore, you might not be able to pull you an angel. And you might not need an angel. You know why you might not need? Now, when I say that, don't get you nobody a steel horn. I'm talking about the past. We make that plain. But what I'm telling you is you might not need somebody with a clean past. You know why? Because they're going to have a certain capacity to handle your past. They're going to have a certain understanding. And what you may be doing is inviting more trouble if you get an angel who has never experienced, because the truth is, just like you need them to be over some stuff, it's still some stuff in you. Can we say amen? Amen? So here's what I tell people. Do it case by case. Most of all, seek God. Because every person is different. Make sure that if it's the past, it is their past. God forgives. God forgets. He removes it, okay? We are not always able to do that. Let me tell you something else. If you know you can't handle it, don't even start it. Because it's going to be a constant problem, okay? So I'll give you a quick answer, and that is make sure it's the past. Make sure that if it's the past, it is the past. Make sure that they're serving God and love God. Be careful who you disqualify because you ain't all that. And it's okay to have high expectations, but be real with yourself too. When I say be real, now how do you balance being real with having good expectations? Because you have to also assess what you're bringing to the table. And then ask yourself, what am I asking for? Am I asking for a miracle or am I asking for what's right for me? Okay? There are some things that are good that just ain't good for you.